Ben Crotty with GRT Avionics. We've got here the Horizon HXR, which is one of the things that's in the panel of the aerodynamics team that flew here at Sebring this weekend. Tell us about your avionics package here.
Well, the Horizon HXR system is a evolution of our HX system. With the HX system and the HXR, we're using the same processor and brains that are behind the proven HX system, and we've expanded it by adding more functionality to the system and larger screens. We've got a 10.4 inch or a 12.1 diagonal screen for the HXRs, and the ability to control remote radios, transponders, audio panels from the screen itself, so you can save yourself on panel space, which is a big concern in a lot of experimental and light sport airplanes.
And that is your niche, is experimental and light sport?
Completely experimental, light sport. We don't do any of the systems that we offer as a certified version for the standard category of aircraft.
Well, take us through some of the features on the HXRs.
Well, on the HXR systems, in the top left-hand corner, you have your engine information along with some more down the sides and in one of the insets on this particular screen. That all comes from our engine information system monitoring your engine's health. And it's completely user-definable. You can put the information that you want to see in the boxes that are provided. Then you have your obvious artificial horizon with the addition of synthetic vision, which comes as a standard on the HXR systems. And with the addition of a GPS, either our external GPS modules or someone else's panel-mounted or handheld GPS that can be integrated with the system, you have moving map flight planning capabilities that'll take you anywhere in the country. With the addition of the remote radios and transponders, audio panels controlled from the top right-hand corner, you can change all of your frequencies with simple button pushes. Then across the bottom, in these two side insets is what we call them, you can change the information that's there to have engine information, traffic information, map pages, or if you're on the main map screen, which is very easy with two button pushes, you can change to the map screen. You still have your primary flight display. In the inset, you have traffic information over here, and you've got a large map area. Our nav database includes all of the frequencies, runways, runway lengths, services provided, anything you'd need to know about an airport that you might want to go into. It's all in the nav database, and you can pull that up through the system while you're en route to an airport, or if you have to change during the route to go to a different airport. With the addition of an ADS-B system, you can use that to display traffic and weather information from any one of a number of different ADS-B manufacturers.
Now, obviously, affordability in the light sport and experimental market is pretty important. So what is the unit going to set someone back?
Well, the basic 10.4 inch HXR display with a single AHARS and our engine monitoring package, basic for anything from a Rotax, Jabiru, Lycoming, will run $7,000 to start. You can add screens, you can add a secondary AHARS for IFR redundancy or just redundancy. We've got three separate power inputs for all of our systems, for the HXR, for the AHARS box, so that if you have multiple buses, if one fails, there's the backup, and it will switch seamlessly between all of those different inputs. We do also offer our own proprietary autopilot, which can be easily retrofitted into a lot of different airplanes that already have an autopilot in the light sport and experimental industry. Our servos, very easy to install, and it's all controlled from the EFIS screen and takes care of climbs, descents, altitude holds. You can track a heading, you can track a GPS course. So any mode of flight that you would want to have the autopilot in use for, you can control it right from the screen.
Great, Ben Crotty from GRT Avionics, thanks very much for taking some time to talk with us on Aero TV.
Thank you.
Aero TV is brought to you by...
No other aircraft explores the limits of the light sport category more than the Carbon Cub SS. It can land and take off in patches that you thought were accessible only to helicopters and hikers, and it does so with a grace, confidence, and control that are Cub hallmarks. If you thought that light sport was just for budget-minded beginners or for veteran pilots stymied by FAA medicals, you simply must fly a Carbon Cub SS. Check us out at www.cubcrafters.com. Are you ready for the next generation of light sport airplanes? Check out the all-new Bristow. Fun, fast and easy to fly. Learn more at www.bristel.com. Pipistrel's innovative new Alpha Trainer has been designed from the ground up for flying school operations. Powered by a Rotax 80-horsepower engine, the Alpha burns only 2.5 U.S. gallons of fuel per hour at 100 to 108 knots, giving you the opportunity to make flight training cost-effective once again. Be sure to check out the Pipistrel Alpha when you're ready to select your next trainer. Get more info at pipistrel-usa.com.